بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Viewers of MTA, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to our program At-Tartil with lesson 8. Assalamu alaikum. Okay. Now, in the previous lessons, we completed the last 6 chapters of the Holy Quran, from Surah Al-Kafirun to Surah An-Nas. Now, you can see here, this is Surah Al-Lahab, chapter 111. Now, I have highlighted only the one letter. You know the rules of letters of prolongation, letters of chirk, and others joining. This letter and also Surah Al-Kawthar, the same Ta has been highlighted. Remember last time I told you about similar sounding letters, that one of the very important areas of pronunciation and recitation of the Holy Quran is to recognize and rightly pronounce the similar sounding letter. We have to recognize, we have to pronounce that letter with its due properties and qualities. Some letters are pronounced with thick sound, some with soft sound. And this Ta, we are going to learn about that one. But first of all, as according to the format of the program, we do some revision. So in this case, we are going to revise Surah Al-Lahab.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
Okay. We have to adopt the same strategy. First of all, I will recite one verse, then you will all follow the next verse, and then one individual in turn will recite one next verse. In this way we will complete. So I will be reciting, you will be listening to me, and then you all together will be reciting, and I will be making assessment of you, and then individual assessment.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب.
ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب.
سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب.
في جيدها حبل من مسد.
You have to continue.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب.
You have to, this is a strong jerk on the last, because tashdeed is there on tab, and also this qalqala, So do again this.
T تَبَّ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبَّ.
Good, well done.
مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبَ.
سَيَصْلَى نَارًا ذَاتَ لَهَبٍ.
وَامْرَأَتُهُ حمالة الحطب.
في جيدها حبل من مسد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب.
Okay, again and again, the same verse is coming to me. Magna anu malu. So we will be, I will be listening the whole surah from each one of you. Okay, so let's try first Tahir and then.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب. ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب. سيصلى نارا ذات لهب. وامرأته حمالة الحطب. في جيدها حبل من مسد.
Okay, next one.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب. ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب. سيصلى نارا ذات لهب. وامرأته حمالة الحطب. في جيدها حبل من مسد.
Okay, جزاكم الله. Thank you very much. حسن.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تب يدا أبي لهب وتب. ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب. سيصلى نارا ذات لهب. وامرأته حمالة الحطب. في جيدها حبل من مسد.
Okay, well done, mashallah. Okay, next one is Surah Al-Kawthar. So I will be reciting the complete surah, and then each one of you will be reciting in turn.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر. فصل لربك وانحر. إن شانئك هو الأبتر.
Okay, please make sure that tha is pronounced with the, you know, softness. Okay, and do again.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Okay, ha should be sharp. Okay, there should not be blunt. Ha, it's coming from the middle of throat, and you have to practice that one. I told you last time as well. Okay, do that.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر.
Okay, good, well done. Okay, Abdullah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر.
Okay, thank you very much, but there are a couple of issues which I like to highlight. First of all, make sure that Lamul Jalala is properly recognized. You know that the Lam of Allah is manifested with thick sound when the previous letter carries Fatha and Dhamma. Now on Bismillahi, on the previous letter carries the Kasra, Zair. Okay? Now it will be pronounced with the empty sound, it will be pronounced with the thin sound. Okay, second one. There are letters of prolongation Alif, Waw and Ya. It should not be prolonged if there is no any other, you know, if there is not condition, you know, the conditional prolongation. Conditional prolongation, as I mentioned last time in previous lessons, when one word is ending on a letters of prolongation, Alif, Waw, and Ya, and the next word is starting with Hamza Alif. Then you can prolong. Otherwise, the original prolongation should not be more than 2 seconds. Okay? Okay, Jazakumullah. Okay, start. Awesome.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inna أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر.
Okay, thank you very much. But I have noticed that the last words, last letter, far, har, atar, you know, these last two letters have not been properly articulated. They have been suffocated, you know, as you start from the beginning very nicely. So it is also a good point of the recitation, rule of recitation, that you start you know, beautifully and end beautifully. Each letter should be pronounced with its due qualities, and no letter should be pronounced with the, you know, it should seem like it has been suffocated. Okay, otherwise, okay, inshallah ta'ala. Okay, this time we are going to learn about fa, which in, you know, with the focus letter, similar sounding letter in this lesson is fa in al-hatab, hammalat al-hatab, and a'atayinak al-kawthar. To pronounce this letter correctly, place the tip of your tongue to the root gum line of top two teeth, you know, the top two teeth and inside the gum line. Now, this is the articulation point of the letter pa. Okay? Make sure that there is two dots, a ta, that is a flat ta. There is no thickness on that letter. But this letter is a letter, its quality, its property is to pronounce with thickness, with full mouth. Pa.
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 Atta.
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 Okay, make sure that when you know the articulation point, first of all, if you know the articulation point, you have recognized that this is the letter where, you know, it will be articulated or pronounced, then you can practice. These are the three examples or three ways. The letter followed by ha with the skun. Ta. Like we say tha, you know, and followed by ha, tha. This is one, you know, mode of practice. The second one is that that you on the letter in focus, and before that the Hamza Alif and Ta with Sukoon, At-ta. Now Ta, make sure that this is a letter of jerk as well, Qalqala as well. So when we are going to make a waqf on that one with Sukoon, it will be a jerking sound, At-ta, but thick. And then because a mushaddad letter, a letter with a tashdeed, is pronounced two times, twice. So that's why I say At-ta. Alright? So points to remember, this letter is always pronounced with thick sound. You know, Lamul Jalala, sometime it is pronounced with thick sound and sometime is with thin sound. There are certain conditions. But this Ta, whether it carries a Fatha, Kasra or Dhamma, this letter will always be pronounced with thick sound. Okay? Second one, the roof of tongue inclines towards the ceiling of mouth. When we say that this letter is thick, it means that when we pronounce that letter, or in order to make a letter thick with full mouth, naturally our roof of our tongue, you know, it inclines towards the ceiling of mouth. So if this is a tongue and the ceiling of mouth, there is a minimum distance in between the two. It inclines towards, otherwise a letter cannot be pronounced with thick sound. If you say Ta, Al-Ta, you will find that in making a difference between symbol Ta and this Ta, this is the difference between the two. Now again, we will do this practice. Ta,
Ta,
Ti,
طه
أطه
أطه
إطه
إطه
أطه
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 أطي
أطي
أطو
أطو.
Alright. Now recite the following words with and without making pause, in the beginning, in the middle, at the end. So I have chosen some words from the Holy Quran where the letter Ta starting in the beginning and in the middle and at the end. And we'll do the practice. Okay, we'll do the practice like, row by row, not column, row, this way, from right to left. Now make sure the first letter is Ta with Kasra and Ba. What we have to do here?
Khalqala.
Well done. So each time our responsibility is increasing, and we are going to practice that one. We are learning a new rule, a new thing, but at the same time we have to remember all the rules learned previously. Tibutun.
Tibutun.
Matla'i.
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 A'ta.
A'ta.
Okay, we'll do that in the same with waqf. Tibutun.
Tibutun.
Matla'i.
Matla.
Now, in this way, you will pronouncing ayn sound as well. Matla.
Matla.
A'ta.
A'ta.
Tin.
Tin.
Yu'tik.
Yu'tik.
Sawt.
Sawt.
Tur.
Tur.
Infatarat.
Infatarat.
Now make sure here Ta and the Ta with Sukoon, you have to make a difference between the two. If you are successfully able to recognize the difference, you have learned that similar sounding letter. Infatarat.
Infatarat.
Muhit.
Muhit.
Tuhaha.
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 I was telling you about the making a difference between, you know, the sharp one and also that ha which is blunt, you know, bottom of throat. This is a good example. Ha, ha. Okay? There's no sharpness on the second one. Tuhaha.
Tuhaha.
Shaytan.
Shaytan.
You see, in ta'awuz we do that. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. You know, you will feel that there is a slight jerk in the letter Ta as well. Slight jerk. You know, Ta is not Ta, simple. little bit, because you know the tongue is inclined towards the ceiling of mouth. Shaytan.
Shaytan.
Tushtit.
Tushtit.
In the previous lesson, I told you about Surah Sad. You know, find out those words of Ana. Maybe you have come across with this word from there. Tushtit.
Tushtit.
Okay, good. Assignment. Identify the letter Ta in the words of first juz, part 1 of the Holy Quran, and recite all of them loudly with moderate voice, medium voice, and make sure this letter is pronounced with thick sound. And at the same time, you should be able to make a difference between the third letter of alphabets, Alif, Ba, Ta. That Ta with two dots is simple, flat, Ta. There's no thickness on that. That letter always be pronounced with thin sound. But this Ta with thick sound. So if this is the first part, can you please open the first part? Okay, so you can go through all that one, you know, and going through, and you can find, for example, here, Wallahu muhitum bil kafirin muhit. We have done already that one. Okay? So Ta is here, and you'll find many examples in this one. So you can go through with this one and make sure that you practice. Okay? Okay. I've just taken that this is do, you know, part one. You can do, after that, you can do part 28, part 18, part 7, because many, many times this, you know, words having Ta have been used in the Holy Quran. But it is important that when you learn a rule, you have to practice a lot. If you learn rule, you say, okay, we know rule, and we know how to pronounce that one, you know, that, you know, thickness. But if you do not practice, then that will be just a theory, okay? And the pronunciation, the recitation is very much based on practice. The recitation, repetition. And then it will become your part of nature. And next time if you recite the Holy Quran with certain similar sounding letters, you don't have to remember all the time that my tongue is inclining towards the ceiling of mouth for thickness or not. Because then that will be your first nature, part of nature. Okay? That will be inherent quality in your pronunciation. Okay? Any question? No question. Okay. Golden rule is that revise and practice and make your own notes. These lessons, remember, are just food for thought and for practice. You can enrich your notes and your other material. Okay? Okay, Jazakumullah. So with this, we conclude our lesson 8, and inshallah ta'ala, we will come with lesson 9, inshallah. Until the next lesson, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلاً.